The Explosion, poem by Philip Larkin. Before moving on to the line-by-line explanation, let me give you a brief intro about this poem. It is an elegy to remember the tragedy of the explosion, and in stanza 1 to 5, the poet describes the event that an explosion deep down a coal mine and the day on which it happened, the day on which the explosion happened. In this way, there are 7 stanzas of 3-3 line each, followed by a single concluding line. And the poet describes a real event and then moves to a reflect on human fate. So let's move on by line by line explanation. On the day of the explosion, so you can see that the poet repeated this first line to the title. So Larkin here intentionally repeats this word explosion because it is the word in the title also, and it is repeated in the first line of the poem also, and it is done intentionally by the poet Philip Larkin. This is done to reveal intentionally to reveal about the tragedy that was about to happen, the explosion that was about to happen. So the poet here says, on the day of the explosion, shadows pointed towards the pit head. That means, on that day when the explosion was about to happen, miners are seen in a physical sense, and Larkin is in a way impersonal, and yet he predicts a catastrophe, and he is not personally involved in what happens to them. So the poet is not personally involved in this explosion, or it is not personally involved in what the miners are going to feel in their life, what kind of event they are going to feel in their life. In the sun, the slag heap slept. Slag heap is some kind of mountain of coal dust, and there the poet is describing that the sun is shining and the slag heap is slept, as if it could awake and do something horrible. Ki agar wo awake hoti, uthi hui hoti, to it could do something horrible. Down the lane came men in pit boots, coughing oath-ish talk in pipe smoke. That means a scene of mine workers arriving to the start their day's work. They are the mine workers are arriving to start their day work, and the men gradually broke the fresh morning silence with comments that soon grew into conversation. They started conversing with each other, and Larkin here states that this conversation contained curses, and some of the men smoked pipes also. One chased after rabbits, lost them, came back with a nest of lark eggs. That means Larkin here describes as one young miner who pursued rabbits and returned with a nest of lark eggs. Lark is a bird. So he returned with the lark eggs that he found and left in the grass after showing them to his mates. Showed them, lodged them in the grasses. That means he showed them to his, he showed the lark eggs to his mates, and then he put them in the grasses. So they passed in beards and moleskins, fathers, brothers, nicknames, laughter, through the tall gate standing open. That means there is a random details of the scene of workers is going on by the poet. It is described by the poet. And their beards and the toughened materials they were wearing, that means the mining clothes. Moleskin means the toughened material, that is the mining clothes. Okay. And there were strong family connections between the men. There was some kind of connection between the men with 2 generations of the male families employed in their mine. Many are known by nicknames and seem to enjoy each other's sense of humor. They all enter the mine area through tall gates. So they all entered through tall gates. And these gates are ominous. That means they are threatening. doomy kind of gates they are, with the suggestion of entering the, so these gates are ominous, these gates are threatening, with the suggestion of entering the gates of heaven or hell. So here it is described that these gates are even itna zyada tall ki they are suggested as the gates of heaven or hell. So they hint this by this way the poet here describes or gives hint about the deaths that is around to come, that is going to come. And it is because it's in the second line he says shadows also, so he is describing that the death is going to come, the some kind of event that is, that will be horrible, that is going to come soon. At noon there came a tremor, cows stopped chewing for a second, sun scarved as in a heat haze dimmed. So Larkin here refers to the man event, the explosion of the title. It happened at midday because at noon it's written now. So it happened at midday and the cows noticed vibration in the ground and they stopped grazing for a moment, just for a moment. The sun, slightly covered by a haze of summer heat, and lost its bright shine. That the sun was totally covered with the haze of summer heat and it lost its bright shine. Perhaps the explosion created of dust haze that partly blocked out the sun. So Larkin here doesn't tell us directly about the underground explosion. Larkin just avoids describing the violence or grief, the predictable aspects of the event. So he avoids telling us directly, he just describes all of this event indirectly to us. And Larkin is detached just by observing that day, by imagining that day from the facts that he read in reports. The dead go on before us. They are sitting in God's house in comfort. God's house means these all three stanzas which are going to come, the last three stanzas, these skip to the church. Okay, so God's house means here church. We shall see them face to face. So all these three stanzas, as I described, they skip to the church services that are held for miners that were killed in that explosion. So we shall see them face to face, plain as lettering in the small chapels. Chapels are small churches. It was said, and for a second, wife saw man of the explosion. So it is a quote from a prayer read at the various funerals. That is read at various funerals, and it is a quote from a prayer. This is an attempt to comfort family members with a reference to heaven. So this God's house of comfort is a quote from a prayer that is read at various funerals to make the family members more comfortable that the dead body, that the soul is going to heaven only. And Larkin imagines here that the widows, they are visualizing their husbands. They are visualizing their husbands. The widows are visualizing their husbands, seeing them more intensely in their mind that they ever did during their lives together. The wife saw their men like figureheads stamped on a gold. This is described in the next stanza, that larger than in life they managed, gold as on a coin, or walking somehow from the sun towards them, one showing the eggs unbroken. So the wife saw their men like the figureheads stamped on a gold coin, or imagined like walking that sunny morning of the explosion towards them in the golden sunlight. Perhaps the wife of the young miner who chased the rabbits has a vision of walking towards her with the next lark eggs. And the last concluding line is, one showing the eggs unbroken. It means it serves as a sense of optimism for the future that the eggs were unbroken. It shows some kind of optimism for the future. And we can talk about some themes that this poem has. Only two themes: that victory of life over death and life and death. So these are the two themes of this poem, and this is how the poem ends.